It's time for your daily crypto update with Framework Fortune. If you joined me last night for the live day trading crypto stream and you're wondering what happened with CTSI eventually, I ended up making a pretty decent profit. It finally did break that 112 area that it kept getting held up at and went on a pretty nice run, but I didn't catch all of this run. I sold parts of it, as you can see right here, 500 at 117, 200 at 120. 200 at 117, 90 at 122, and 90 at 123. So I was able to make a decent little profit, about an $80 profit on that crypto trade. But boy, did I leave a lot of money on the table. Currently, CTSI is consolidating. It looks like we may have another triangle forming. So you may be able to look for something there. But just keep in mind that this is way off of the trend line and this did rip 60 something cents overnight, pretty much. Like for all you Bitcoiners out there who got a little nervous with that downtrend on Bitcoin, that has finally broke, so we can remove that downtrend, pushing up for a new recent high, testing that 60,000 area. So at this point, we just want to see Bitcoin break over 60,000 and then it could go on another run. Dogecoin, which is getting a lot of hype because Elon Musk is on SNL tonight. I don't know what it's all about, if he's going to mention Dogecoin, but I've been seeing a lot on social media about it. Just kind of in this sloped trading range, did bounce off of that 60 cent area and it's looking to curl up again. So if a lot of hype comes into Dogecoin, we could possibly see it to $1 tonight. But don't be surprised if some pump and dump type of action happens. Usually in the stock market, when something is getting pushed all over the place, social media, there's going to be some very volatile moves, just like we saw with GameStop and other cryptos. Be prepared for Dogecoin to possibly turn around. This is kind of a weird, unique situation with Dogecoin, so I really don't know which way it's going to go. Either way, I would just be cautious and understand that there is no cap on the circulating supply of how many Dogecoin are out there unless something changes. But we'll see what happens tonight with Dogecoin and see if it gets up to that dollar area. Ether, as we've been watching, and I said was on this little triangle, broke out of this triangle, nice move up almost to $4,000 today. So Ether's on fire, so that's bringing some heat into the market as well. Right now it's pretty high up there, consolidating a little bit below 4,000. We do have some nice support that has started to build right here. This was resistance back in this area, and now it's held up multiple times of support, including this most recent candle at about 3850. So it may consolidate around here, but we could see Ethereum break over 4,000 here very soon. Dash, which I've been talking about quite a bit, has broken out of this downtrend triangle on the 5 minute. On the 4 hour, it still does look like it's testing a little bit. But I would say if Ethereum starts moving and Dogecoin, we'll probably see Dash start to move as well. Right around that $400 area, it was resistance back here, but it looks like it's trying to find support in that area and it's starting to curl up and break this downtrend. So we could see Dash maybe push back up to that 500 area, maybe in the next couple of days, sometime next week. StormX, one that I've been keeping an eye on, it is still going sideways, getting closer and closer to this uptrend. I'm still looking for a possible bounce on this, or if it to hold up right here in this 5 cent area and then break the downtrend. So StormX is still definitely on watch. EOS has had some nice pops on the way down, but it is still currently in a downtrend. Like to see EOS break out of that soon. If it doesn't, we could see it back down to this 950, maybe even this $9 area. The biggest story of the day, the biggest ripper so far, is Shiba Inu. I don't know what exchanges this is on. It doesn't even look like you can get it with US dollar. You have to get it with USDT, but it has ran 461%. If you threw some chunks of money into Shiba down here at these cheap prices, you're sitting pretty right now. I'm not familiar with this at all, but I figured it was worth pointing out that we did have a 461% runner today. Waves, which you've been keeping an eye on, is actually making a pretty nice triangle. It's trying to find support in this 32 area. We could see it curl back up and try to test around that 34, 30 area maybe tomorrow. And if it does, we could see Waves continue its bull run. If not, if it cracks this, then it's got a ways to drop, and then we could see it all the way back down at this 23 area. So if this triangle doesn't break, this could be a bit of a risky play. But that's it for the daily crypto update. And remember, if there's any coins that you want me to cover, leave them in the comments below. And if you know anything about the Shiba Inu, let me know about that as well. I'm your host, Ben. You've been watching Framework Fortune Crypto Daily. Until next time.